I'm happy to be here with Minister Anasangiri and MPs Kellaway and Batiste on this special day. It's a special day, of course, because it is National Indigenous Peoples Day. La Journée Nationale des Peuples Autochtones, c'est un moment pour tous les Canadiens de se rassembler ce premier jour de l'été pour célébrer les cultures, les histoires et les traditions des Premières Nations, des Inuits et des Métis. From elders to knowledge keepers to political leaders and protectors of our lands and waters, we recognize your important contributions. It's also a special day because together we just took another significant step on the path of reconciliation between the Crown and Wagoma. After many years of negotiations and different governments, as the Chief pointed out, the proposed settlement agreement of $125 million we are about to sign will resolve the claim regarding the improper sale of reserve land in 1862. This is reconciliation in action. But that's not all. Today, we're also announcing another positive step in the right direction. The federal government will deliver more than $16 million a year in increased funding to Mi'kmaq Gunamutnoi to maintain, repair, and replace their existing education infrastructure. Ce financement va permettre aux communautés, dont 3000 élèves, d'avoir les ressources nécessaires pour réussir tout en conservant un lien avec la culture et la langue Mi'kmaq. This is on top of existing funding of more than $125 million over the next 5 years for education governance and education infrastructure, which means the operation and delivery of high-quality education in your schools right across the province, including here in Wagoma. Since the beginning, our government has been focused on fairness, this idea that everyone in every generation deserves a real and fair chance at success. And fairness, of course, starts with better access to education for everyone. Schools and teachers should have the resources they need. Education systems should be able to answer the unique needs of students in their communities, because we know that education helps improve people's quality of life, it helps reduce poverty and build stronger communities, and connects young people with their language, their culture, their elders, their stories, and most importantly, their identity. Today on Indigenous Peoples Day, but every day across this country, we need to value and recognize and celebrate Indigenous peoples and the cultures, languages, and strengths that they have always brought to this extraordinary land. Indeed, the work we've done means that since 2016, there's been close to a 50% increase of Indigenous peoples who have a post-secondary degree. For First Nations, that number is now over 60%. High school graduation rates in First Nations across Nova Scotia have also continued to soar. So let's keep working together to make sure kids have what they need to succeed from coast to coast to coast. Tout le monde mérite une chance équitable de réussir. Les annonces qu'on fait aujourd'hui avec les membres des Premières Nations en Nouvelle-Écosse vont aider à bâtir des communautés plus fortes. We will always be a partner in building a better future for Indigenous peoples, a future to be determined by all of you. Whether it's by investing in education, housing, or healthcare, or creating good jobs and enabling projects owned by Indigenous peoples, or funding the work to revitalize Indigenous languages, reconciliation will always be at the forefront of everything we do. More opportunities, more jobs, more homes, and fairness for every generation right across the country. Thank you. Merci. Wélalaliuk. Happy National Indigenous Peoples Day. Merci beaucoup, mes amis.